You remember this guy?
Yeah, he used to work here, but I fired him. Guy was always late to work. Sometimes he didn't show up at all.
How long ago?
2 weeks.
Any idea where he went?
Yeah, he hopped the bus headed for L.A.
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure. Why? What's he done?
We want to talk to him about a bank robbery in Kansas City.
Figures. I knew the guy was trouble.
Hi, baby, it's me.
Yeah. I'll call the FBI office in L.A. We'll knock off and we'll go get something to eat. That is, of course, unless you don't have a date with Ann.
No, she's at a cello recital.
She plays the cello?
Yeah. So?
Wait a second. This girl, she plays the cello.
Mm-hmm.
She recites poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And she collects Japanese art?
Yeah, so?
I mean, what doesn't this girl do?
She doesn't bowl.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. I beg your...
I should have been watching where I was going.
I should be watching where you're going.
Has anybody ever told you, miss, that miss... Nah, I had it last night.
So what? Well, you know that Oriental waitress over at Lucky Stuff?
Look at that.
Hey! Hey!
At least you could have done what said thanks.
We sure can't pick him.
Next thing I know, two guys are trying to force this girl into a car and wearing a gun. Yeah, fine. Thanks.
Teresa Ferrantino. She had a Chicago ID, so I called Chief Kramer. She's married to Frankie Ferrantino. You remember him?
Frankie the dude.
Yeah.
Bagman for Vito Maggio. We arrested him once for armed robbery.
Not your standard women's cosmetic kit, is it?
Well, there's more. Kramer doesn't know why, But Vito Maggio and Frankie Ferentino had this real heavy beef. Mm-hmm. And ever since then, Frankie boy's been on the run.
Yeah. The ID on one of these stiffs says he's Jackie Prince. You know who I think he works for?
Vito Maggio.
Yeah.
All right, so what we have is Frankie Ferentino on the run. His wife comes to Las Vegas. Two of Vito Maggio's guys tried to grab her. Which means what?
Well, but they want to use Teresa to lead him to Frankie.
Maggio must want Frankie pretty bad.
You're right. But if we can get to Frankie before Vito Maggio's guys do, maybe we can flip him, turn him into a federal witness against Vito Maggio.
If we can find Ferentino.
Mike! This is Rusty Miller, the cabbie that Teresa Ferentino skipped out of here with.
No kidding.
Nice work.
Thanks.
So what do you hear from Chen?
Chen wants to talk. He's got shipments piling up in Macau. He wants to see some movement.
It's too bad. Business takes time.
Chen wants action, not axioms.
It's not our mission in life to make Chen happy. You're the diplomat around here, David. So go be diplomatic.
All right, Ray.
Just get out of my way.
I've got my orders.
You knew who I was. You don't want to see me. Get out of my way!
Hello, Ray.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lucas. She got past me.
Teresa? That's all, Howard.
Teresa, you look terrific.
Is that a you, Paulie?
Thank you.
I know. So when did you get into Vegas?
Just a little while ago.
Paulie, just don't stand there. Give the lady a drink. Bourbon, right?
You remembered.
Some things you don't forget. Say hello to Max Goldman.
Yeah, charmed.
This is nice, Ray. You've come a long way from the patch.
Yeah, well, I'm doing all right. So, that's Frankie.
You know how he is. He's in trouble.
Stay away from him, Teresa. That's my advice.
I don't need your advice, Ray. I need your help to get Frankie off the hook.
There's nothing I can do. You want to talk Chicago? You talk to Vito. This is Vegas. I'm not involved.
You're not involved? Those two goons who tried to grab me at the bus station just wanted a date, right?
What goons?
Come on, Ray. Someone made a move on me. You telling me it was the welcome wagon?
If Vito made a move on you, I don't know anything about it.
Then call him.
You know that's not the way it works.
Damn you. Frankie was your friend.
Frankie was a guy I knew. We were never friends.
What about me? We were friends.
That was a long time ago, Teresa. And it's got nothing to do with Frankie.
Please, Ray. I love him.
Walk away, Teresa. Frankie is a dead man. He just doesn't know it.
Hey, what did I do?
Have you ever loved anything, Ray? Anything at all?
Yeah. But I broke the habit.
It's a real sweetheart, Ray.
You know, I always liked that, Brock.
Yeah. She's got more stones than Frankie ever had. What a waste. Paulie.
Yeah?
Give me Vito in Chicago.
Mrs. Ferentino.
We're with the Justice Department.
Should have known you were cops.
We thought you'd like this bag. I kept the gun.
Figures.
Want to tell us what's going on?
Tell you about what?
We know that Vito Maggio is looking for Frankie. Why?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about keeping Frankie alive. Now, are we going to play games or are we going to help you?
I don't need your help. You know, I never met a cop who wasn't on the take or who wasn't owned by some family or other. Who owns you? Ray Luca?
Nobody.
Then you must be a saint, and I don't believe in saints.
I think we found Frankie.
How long ago did it happen?
Half an hour. Blew out a door, a window, and a wall into the next room. Fortunately, nobody was inside. The bomb squad thinks it was nitro placed under the bed with an anti-disturbance device. This guy registered as Les Gennard, but his driver's license says Frank Ferrantino.
Oh, God, no!
Anything to make a positive identification of?
Hand.
Al.
Teresa, I think you should tell us what's going on.
Vito's sister, Maria, had the hots for Frankie. She hit on him. He told her he wasn't interested. So she got mad and told her brother that Frankie tried to rape her.
Vito put a contract out on Frankie.
Please, if you don't need me anymore, I'd like to go.
You have a place to stay?
I do. I have a room waiting for me at the Golden Key Motel. I'll take a cab.
See the fingernails on that hand? What about them? They were filthy and they were bitten.
So?
So they call him Frankie the Dude because he was a very sharp dresser. This was not the kind of guy that bit his fingernails. This was the kind of guy that got a manicure twice a day. Now, I don't know whose hand they have there, but I doubt very much that it's Frankie's.
Huh?
So, who did they find at the motel?
How the hell should I know? Vito's guys came after me. I split from there.
Thank God you weren't there. Where were you?
Trying to help you.
Trying to help me? What's that supposed to mean?
I, went to see Ray Luca.
You went to see Luca?
Don't be mad at me, please. Please, I thought maybe he could talk to Vito and straighten things out for you. Frankie, I was only trying to help.
Help? How? What, by keeping his bed warm at night?
But I know all about you and Ray Luca.
Frankie, that's ancient history. We were kids.
What the hell is this?
We were just in the neighborhood. We thought we'd stop by and say hello.
Yeah, well, I didn't do nothing.
What's the matter, Frankie? You slipping?
You sold me out.
We followed her.
You are so stupid.
Hey, hey, hey. Take a look around.
Get easy. Wait a minute. I know you, don't I? I used to be a cop in Chicago. Mike Torello, major crime unit. What's the matter? Chicago hoods don't pay enough.
Pardon me?
I said Chicago hoods don't pay enough. Get out.
Frankie, what's going on?
Shut up, you trap.
Look what I got here. Liquid mercury.
Sets off a hell of a bomb.
Put the cuffs on this puke.
It's a pretty cute trick, Frankie. Blow up some poor slob, makes the world think you're dead.
You've got an overactive imagination, you know that?
Oh, I love imagining you in the electric chair.
That's if Vito's boys don't take him out in prison first.
You can bet they'll try. I ain't scared.
Then you must be pretty damn dumb. If I were you, I'd be real scared. If you were smart, you would let us help you.
So what, all I gotta do is roll over, is that right?
Nothing wrong with a new identity, a new place to live.
We'll even get you a prettier face, if you want it.
Well, I'm sorry, guys, but it just don't come any prettier than this, you know?
I've never seen a pretty face on a corpse. Have you? Get this dreck out of here.
Come on, gorgeous.
Get up.
Vito, it's good to see you.
Ray, you look like a million bucks.
I feel even better, too. You know, Max, I'd like you to meet David Abrams.
Oh, I remember your father when I was just coming up. Izzy the dancer. He was a good man, but a small-timer.
Hey, the way I heard it, you were happy to run my father's errands.
Oh, that's the wonderful thing about this business. One day you're on the bottom, the next day you're on the top of the world. Right, Ray?
Vito, go make yourself comfortable. Paulie, give Vito a drink, all right?
And is that, huh?
Excuse us, will you, David? Listen, I want you to stay on top of that Chan business, all right? Hey, David, don't let him bother you. He's operating on three cylinders.
The old guys told me it was only yesterday it used to be desert. Nothing but cactus and sand. Now look at it.
You don't visit us enough, Vito.
We got a problem, Ray. A very big problem.
I know, Vito. That's why I asked you to come here.
What if the feds were to find Farentino? That punk makes a deal with them, it could be very dangerous for me. For the entire Chicago outfit.
I understand that, Vito. But this is my town.
I know, and I'm sorry if my people stepped on your toes. They should have checked with me before they made their move, but they thought the girl could lead them to Farentino.
Manny has asked me to handle Frankie personally. You're welcome to stay in Vegas as long as you like. Go gambling, dance and see some shows. Better yet, go play some golf.
Thank you, Ray.
Manny's worried. Vito's unpredictable. If Frankie testifies and Vito gets indicted, Manny's afraid that Vito will roll over on the outfit rather than go to jail.
Vito's a stand-up guy, don't worry about it.
Maybe. But we're gonna be sure. Frankie's gotta be dealt with.
Hey, boss, let me handle it. I can handle it, ain't no problem.
A situation like this, you bring an out-of-town help. We don't need any extra heat. Go ahead, Max, make the call.
Operator, get me New York.
Information to you. Here you go.
Speaking.
How many clients?
Hey. Come on, sir.
Yeah.
Two.
Yeah. Hey.
Charles. I heard so. I think three.
Yeah. All right. Get your.
Listen, baby, I gotta get out of here. Now. Just do it.
That offer that you made, immunity and a new identity in exchange for his testimony, is it still good?
I can call Washington.
Then do it, please, before something happens.
Teresa.
What?
You were supposed to meet Frankie at that motel room, right?
Yeah, so?
So how come he didn't ask you to meet him at the Golden Key?
What are you saying?
I'm saying that you were supposed to be in that motel room when it blew up.
No way, you're crazy.
If your body would have been identified, there would have been no question about who the other corpse was. The police and the outfit would have thought that Frankie was dead.
You're sick, you know that? While you're talking, he could be getting killed. Now, does he have a deal?
Yeah, he's got a deal.
Thank you.
We're with the Department of Justice. We have a court order to take Frank Farentino into federal custody.
Vito, I said I would handle it.
Right, Ray, the move was already in motion. There was nothing I could do. Besides, my business is my business. I'll take care of it the way I see fit.
That's great, Vito. But I won't say this again. This is my town. And in my town, only one person calls the shots. Me.
All right, Ray, start as it. What's done is done. But now Torello's got Farentino. You know what that means? He rolls over on me. I'm finished.
I don't care about Torello. I said I would handle it.
Hey, boss,
I just got word from our guy downtown. Terrell, he's got Frankie stashed in the penthouse of the Four Kings.
You sure?
Well, I'm positive.
There. You see? So what are you worried about, huh?
Hey, Ray, I'm counting on you.
Vito, that's all I ask. Listen, you go back and play those nine holes. And when you get ready to putt the ninth green, you give me a call. I'll have some good news for you, all right?
Hey, thanks, Ray.
Hey, it's my pleasure, Vito.
This guy, he's got some nerve, huh, boss?
Yeah, he thinks like a mustache from the old days. He belongs in the Museum of Natural History.
So, what are you gonna do about it?
Do, Paulie. It's done.
Do you have enough to eat, Joey?
I'm hungry. I'm boxing again, Mike, a couple times a week down at the gym.
Oh, you're in training, huh?
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter? You don't get enough excitement on this jet?
This detail isn't exactly thrilling.
You gotta trust me.
I gotta trust you. Trust you for what? What are you kidding me? You think I'm stupid? I know.
Come on, that was so long.
Who is it?
It's me, Michael.
Stop it!
Huh?
Stop it!
How's it going? That's how.
True romance and hi-fi and technical.
We've danced with some pretty crummy characters in our time, Mike, but this guy, he's in a class all by himself.
Yeah, somewhere between a bacteria and a disease.
We don't have to love him. All we have to do is keep him alive. What about her?
You don't listen to me. You never listen to me. Frankie, no! Frankie!
Leave her alone. You want to get tough with somebody? Get tough with me, big guy. Come on. Come on. Come on, tough guy. Come on, tough guy.
Hey! Hey. It's not worth it. Come here, donut.
You okay? We're supposed to be protecting this stool pigeon. All I want to do is murder him.
Come on, Mike. Take it easy.
Hey. She ain't running away from him.
Look, Frankie didn't mean nothing.
I'm buying you a drink.
I don't want no drink.
Yes, you do. Come on. Why do you let him do it?
He doesn't mean anything. He's just frustrated. He's under a lot of pressure.
He's a jerk.
He loves me.
Yeah, I can see that.
Don't you think sometimes I think about telling him to kiss off?
Why don't you?
Because I'm scared. I mean, I don't know where I leave off and he begins.
Teresa, you don't need Frankie. All you really need is yourself.
There was a lot of love in the beginning. Back when I was trying to make it as a dancer. You know, Frankie and I met right here in Vegas. Used to work at this place called Cyril's off of Fremont Street. Man, oh man, what a class joint. Frankie used to come in, stay both shows just to see me. After the place closed, I used to go over there just to look at it, to remember the good times when Frankie wasn't like he is now.
People change, Teresa. You have to see Frankie for what he is now. Not for what he was.
Maybe. But I love him.
You called.
them out.
Three nines?
All right. King high straight.
How do you get that nine?
Full boat, ladies over trays. If we was playing for money, boys, I think I'd have, what, about a year's salary by now?
If we were playing for money, you'd have about two broken hands by now.
What do you mean?
He cheats. So sue me.
Whose deal?
Mine.
You stealing my wife or what?
Well, somebody ought to, Frankie. Somebody ought to take her right away from you.
Deal with the waiter.
I gave him the night off.
Let's do it.
All right, last hand. AC Deucey, One-Eyed Jacks are wild. Spit, Black Mariah. Low spade in the hole, splits the pot.
What? Don't worry, Joe, you're not in.
All right.
I'm sorry, baby. I really am.
Yes, sure.
But I know I don't deserve you. I don't know why you stay with me. I mean, if you had any sense, you'd leave me. I mean, you might as well. I'm a dead man anyway.
The feds will keep you alive.
Yeah, sure they will.
Why do you hit me, Frankie?
Maybe because I'm jealous.
I wouldn't leave you. You know that. I couldn't.
Baby, I testify at this hearing. I'm a dead man. No matter what, the outfit's gonna kill me.
What else can we do?
We can take off.
How?
I don't know, but... we gotta keep our eyes open, because when the chance comes, we gotta be ready.
Frankie, even if we could get out of here, where are we gonna go? We don't have any money.
You're wrong. You're wrong, baby. We got all the money there is.
What are you talking about?
You're just gonna have to trust me, because I got it covered.
There is nothing to this game. Where are you guys going? I was just getting warmed up.
Well, we're gonna get some sleep. We'll be back in a few hours to spell you.
Be on time, will you?
Yeah. Well, we'll phone you from downstairs so we don't embarrass you when you catch you sleeping.
Hey, relax. If they make a move, it'll happen tomorrow when we take Frankie to the airport.
Get out of here.
Here, Joey.
Good night, my
sweet dreams. I'm gonna go upstairs and check on Ozzy and Harriet.
Yeah, how do you like that kid's luck, huh, Nate?
Oh,
he must be taking lessons from Frankie.
You know, that kid isn't as dumb as I give him credit for. I'm tapped out.
What? Busted? Broke?
No bread?
Shut up.
Out of cash?
Food order.
I'll get it. It's the room service I ordered. Just put it over there.
Yes, sir.
Get me.
Ah. Ah. Ah.
You all right?
Yeah.
Try to get out of Vegas, but they won't try to make a move until tonight. Danny, we get anything back on the dead gunman yet?
Yeah, I just talked to the FBI. Physical description sounds like a guy out of New York named Jerry Sturmer. Runs with a partner, Bobby Tucker. The real high line hitters.
Frankie's still in big trouble.
The photos are coming over the telecopier any minute.
All right, I want everyone on the streets with photographs of Ferrantino and the shooter. Send copies to the Las Vegas Police Department. We get any photographs of Teresa yet?
No, nothing.
Damn it.
Mike. That was Chief Kramer in Chicago. Teresa's been selling us a bill of goods. Vito doesn't want Frankie for trying to rape his sister. He wants him for stealing $2 million.
$2 million?
Yeah. A couple of weeks ago, he went to make a pickup. Never came back.
I'll lay your odds Frankie never intended to testify. He was just waiting for a chance to take off.
And Teresa thinks she's going with him?
Only place Frankie's taking Teresa is the grave.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah.
Sometimes here, huh, Frankie? Me dancing, you watching.
Yeah, I remember this place. They used to look at me like I didn't belong here. Waiters and the customers. Nice to sit in the back and watch you dance. Watching their jaws hit the floor. Thinking I may not be their class, but I got you. That's all that matters.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you something else.
What?
It's a good thing you got a beautiful body, baby, because you sure couldn't dance.
You always say the right thing, don't you, Frankie?
No, this is really good. Tonight we get a car. Tomorrow we're going to be knocking back tequilas and listening to mariachi.
We need money to get to Mexico, Frankie, and I don't see any.
Hey, baby, I told you, I got that covered. We are sitting on a fortune.
How?
I stole a big chunk of Vito's dough.
Is that what this is all about? God, are you crazy? How could you?
How could I, baby? It's like the guy said about Everest, all right? It was there, you know? I'm tired of being a punk, and that money is our ticket out of here. Now, we can go anywhere and do anything.
Yeah, with the outfit chasing us for the rest of our lives.
All right, it's in a suitcase, and it's stashed in a pawn shop. Now, you're gonna have to pick it up because I'm hotter than a $3 bill.
Yeah, and what do you think I'm not?
Baby, I told you. I got it all covered.
Let's go back downtown. You see, once they had the money, they'd find some place to duck for a while.
Yeah, but where? I mean, there's a million places they could hold up in this town. For my money, the downtown area is the best bet.
No, no. They would go to some place that was familiar, some place that they would know.
Well, we're back to square one.
It's just like I said, let's go check downtown again.
Frankie?
Leave it to me, you said. I'll take care of everything, Vito. You blew it, Ray. Torello's got Fiorentino, and he's still got my money.
Vito, calm down. You're gonna give yourself a heart attack. You want an anisette?
Paulie.
Give Vito an anisette.
What I want is Fiorentino dead. What I don't want is that punk singing at any grand jury. I do not want to spend the rest of my life in the joint.
Yeah, hello.
I said I would handle it.
Hey, boss.
Not now, Paulie.
Boss, it's that Teresa Fiorentino brought. She wants to talk to you.
How are you, Teresa?
Hello, Ray.
You're crazy, you know that? You got everybody in town looking for you, and you call me.
I got a present for you, Ray. You know Cyril's?
Yeah, the old club on the south side. So what?
Frankie's holed up there. You better hurry, though, before he wakes up.
You know, I always said you had guts. But I never figured you for brains.
Yeah, well, I'm getting smarter.
How do you like your crow, Vito?
I don't get it.
What?
I still can't figure it with this broad. This guy, he treats her like a human speed bag and she still runs after him. I mean, what is it with this broad? Money?
No, it's not money, Danny. It's about memories.
Where are we going?
To a nightclub.
Teresa? Teresa?
That lying little tramp. Hey, baby, you had me worried.
Ambulance. I need a doctor.
Ow. You'll live. It's like you're gonna testify whether you want to or not, huh, Frankie?
Ann and I are going bowling. If I got a kidnap.
I thought you'd be on your way to Rio by now.
I don't want the money.
Uncle Sam will. Have a seat.
Thanks. I'm the one who set up Frankie. I told Luca where to find him.
I figured.
Look what I found.
Ticket to Tahiti, for one.
You were right about him. He never really loved me. He wasn't planning on taking me with him. So I'm an accessory in what happens to Frankie?
Well, Frankie will testify against Maggio. Maggio will go down pretty hard. Take a pretty big chunk out of the Chicago outfit. But you won't have to shed any more tears over him. You have a clean slate. You can start a new life.
Yeah. Father made a decent guy, and it turns out he's a cop.
Yeah, well, that's the way the cookie crumbles.
DiMaggio, you are indicted. Leave me alone!
You think Frank Ferrantino is a liar?
Never heard of the guy.
If Ferrantino's testimony results in your being indicted, what does that mean for Manny Weisbord?
Weisbord? Why don't you ask him? Luca's gonna pay for this.
Hi, baby, it's me.
Yeah. I'll call the FBI office in L.A. We'll knock off and we'll go get something to eat. That is, of course, unless you don't have a date with Ann.
No, she's at a cello recital.
She plays the cello?
Yeah. So?
Oh, wait a second. This girl, she plays the cello.
Mm-hmm.
She recites poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And she collects Japanese art?
Yeah, so?
I mean, what doesn't this girl do?
She doesn't bowl.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me. I beg your...
I should have been watching where I was going.
Oh, I... No, I should be watching where you're going. Has anybody ever told you, Miss, that Miss...
I had last night.
So what? Well, you know that Oriental waitress over at Lucky Stuff?
Look at that.
Hey! Hey!
At least you could have done what said thanks.
You sure can't pick them.
remember this guy?
Yeah, he used to work here, but I fired him. Guy was always late to work. Sometimes he didn't show up at all.
How long ago?
2 weeks.
Any idea where he went?
Yeah, he hopped a bus headed for L.A.
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure. Why? What's he done?
We want to talk to him about a bank robbery in Kansas City.
Figures. I knew the guy was trouble.
Hi, baby, it's me.
Yeah. I'll call the FBI office in L.A. We'll knock off and we'll go get something to eat. That is, of course, unless you don't have a date with Ann.
No, she's at a cello recital.
She plays the cello?
Yeah. So?
Wait a second. This girl, she plays the cello.
Mm-hmm.
She recites poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And she collects Japanese art?
Yeah, so?
I mean, what doesn't this girl do?
She doesn't bowl.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. I beg your...
I should have been watching where I was going.
I should be watching where you're going.
Has anybody ever told you, Miss, that Miss...
I had last night.
So what? Well, you know that warrior at the waitress over the lucky stuff?
Look at that.
Hey! Hey!
Hi, baby, it's me.
Yeah. I'll call the FBI office in L.A. We'll knock off and we'll go get something to eat. That is, of course, unless you don't have a date with Ann.
No, she's at a cello recital.
She plays the cello?
Yeah. So?
Wait a second. This girl, she plays the cello.
Mm-hmm.
She recites poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And she collects Japanese art?
Yeah, so?
I mean, what doesn't this girl do?
She doesn't bowl.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. I beg your...
I should have been watching where I was going.
I should be watching where you're going.
Has anybody ever told you, Miss, that Miss...
I had last night.
So what? Well, you know that warrior at the waitress over the lucky stuff?
Look at that.
Hey! Hey!
least you could have done was said thanks.
You sure can't pick them.
My business is my business. I'll take care of it the way I see fit.
That's great, Vito. But I won't say this again. This is my town. And in my town, only one person calls the shots. Me!
All right, Ray. Stata zit. What's done is done. But now Torello's got Farentino. You know what that means? He rolls over on me. I'm finished.
I don't care about Torello. I said I would handle it.
Hey, boss, I just got word from our guy downtown.
Torello, he's got Frankie stashed in the penthouse of the Four Kings.
You sure?
Well, I'm positive.
There. You see? So what are you worried about, huh?
Hey, Ray, I'm counting on you.
Vito, that's all I ask. Listen, you go back and play those nine holes. And when you get ready to putt the ninth green, you give me a call. I'll have some good news for you, all right?
Hey, thanks, Ray.
Hey, it's my pleasure, Vito.
This guy, he's got some nerve, huh, boss?
Yeah, he thinks like a mustache from the old days. He belongs in the Museum of Natural History.
So, what are you gonna do about him?
Do Paulie. It's done.
Do you have enough to eat, Joey?
I'm hungry. I'm boxing again, Mike, a couple times a week down at the gym.
Oh, you're in training, huh?
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter? You don't get enough excitement on this jet?
This detail isn't exactly thrilling.
Who is it?
It's me, Michael.
Stop it.
Huh? How's it going? That's how.
True romance and hi-fi and technical.
We've danced with some pretty crummy characters in our time, Mike, but this guy, he's in a class all by himself.
Yeah, somewhere between a bacteria and a disease.
We don't have to love him. All we have to do is keep him alive.
What about her?
Frankie, no! Frankie!
Leave her alone.
Want to get back? You're alive.
Yes, I'm.
So, who did they find at the motel?
What the hell should I know? Vito's guys came after me. I split from there. Thank God you weren't there. Where were you?
Trying to help you.
Trying to help me? What's that supposed to mean?
I, went to see Ray Luca.
You went to see Luca?
Don't be mad at me, please. I thought maybe he could talk to Vito and straighten things out for you. Frankie, I was only trying to help.
Help? How? What, by keeping his bed warm at night? But I know all about you and Ray Luca.
Frankie, that's ancient history. We were kids.
What the hell is this?
We were just in the neighborhood. We thought we'd stop by and say hello.
Yeah, well, I didn't do nothing.
What's the matter, Frank? You slipping?
You sold me out.
We followed her.
You were so stupid.
Hey, hey, hey!
Take a look around.
Get easy. Wait a minute. I know you, don't I? Used to be a cop in Chicago. Mike Torello, major crime unit. What's the matter? Chicago hoods don't pay enough.
Pardon me?
I said Chicago hoods don't pay enough.
Frankie, what's going on?
Shut up, you trap.
Look what I got here. Liquid mercury.
Sets off a hell of a bomb.
Put the cuffs on this puke.
It's a pretty cute trick, Frankie. blow up some poor slob makes the world think you're dead.
You've got an overactive imagination, you know that?
Oh, I love imagining you in the electric chair.
That's if Vito's boys don't take him out in prison first.
You can bet they'll try.
I ain't scared.
Then you must be pretty damn dumb. If I were you, I'd be real scared. If you were smart, you would let us help you.
So what, all I gotta do is roll over, is that right?
Nothing wrong with a new identity, a new place to live.
We'll even get you a prettier face, if you want it.
Well, I'm sorry, guys, but it just don't come any prettier than this, you know?
I've never seen a pretty face on a corpse. Have you? Get this dreck out of here.
Come on, gorgeous.
Get up.
Vito, it's good to see you.
Ray, you look like a million bucks.
I feel even better, too. You know, Max, I'd like you to meet David Abrams.
Oh, I remember your father when I was just coming up. Izzy the dancer. He was a good...
All right, last hand. AC Deucey, One-Eyed Jacks Are Wild, Spit, Black Mariah, Low Spade in the Hole, Splits the Pot.
What?
Don't worry, Joe, you're not in.
All right. I'm sorry, baby. I really am.
Yes, sure.
And I know I don't deserve you. I don't know why you stay with me. I mean, if you had any sense, you'd leave me. I mean, you might as well. I'm a dead man anyway.
Feds will keep you alive. Why do you hit me, Frankie?
Maybe because I'm jealous.
I wouldn't leave you. You know that. I couldn't.
Baby, I testify at this hearing. I am a dead man. No matter what, the outfit's gonna kill me.
What else can we do?
We can take off.
How?
I don't know, but... We gotta keep our eyes open, because when the chance comes, we gotta be ready.
Frankie, even if we could get out of here, where are we gonna go? We don't have any money.
Wrong. You're wrong, baby. We got all the money there is.
What are you talking about?
You're just gonna have to trust me, because I got it covered.
There is nothing to this game. Where are you guys going? I was just getting warmed up.
Well, we're gonna get some sleep. We'll be back in a few hours to spell you.
Be on time, will you?
Yeah. Well, we're phoning you from downstairs so we don't embarrass you when we catch you sleeping.
Hey, relax. If they make a move, it'll happen tomorrow when we take Frankie to the airport. Get out of here.
Here, Joey.
Good night, Mike.
Sweet dreams.
I'm gonna go upstairs and check on Ozzy and Harriet.
Yeah, how do you like that kid's luck, huh, Nate?
Oh,
you must be taking lessons from Frankie.
You know, that kid isn't as dumb as I give him credit for. I'm tapped out.
What? Busted?
Broke?
No bread?
Yeah. Out of cash?
Food order.
I'll get it. It's the room service I ordered.
Personally. You're welcome to stay in Vegas as long as you like. Go gambling, dance and see some shows. Better yet, go play some golf.
Thank you, Ray.
Manny's worried. Vito's unpredictable. If Frankie testifies and Vito gets indicted, Manny's afraid that Vito will roll over on the outfit rather than go to jail.
If
Vito's a stand-up guy, don't worry about it.
Maybe. But we gotta be sure. Frankie's gotta be dealt with.
Hey, boss, let me handle it. I can handle it, ain't no problem.
A situation like this, you bring an out-of-town help. We don't need any extra heat. Go ahead, Max, make the call.
Operator, get me New York.
Information to you. Here you go.
Speaking.
How many clients?
Hey. Come on, sir.
Yeah.
Two.
Yeah. Hey.
Charles. I heard some. I think three.
Yeah. Hey. Get your.
I gotta make a phone call.
All right, listen, baby, I gotta get out of here now. Just do it.
That offer that you made, immunity and a new identity in exchange for his testimony, is it still good?
I can call Washington.
Then do it, please, before something happens.
Teresa.
What?
You were supposed to meet Frankie at that motel room, right?
Yeah, so?
So how come he didn't ask you to meet him at the Golden Key?
What are you saying?
I'm saying that you were supposed to be in that motel room when it blew up.
No way. You're crazy.
If your body would have been identified, there would have been no question about who the other corpse was. The police and the outfit would have thought that Frankie was dead.
You're sick, you know that? While you're talking...
Golden Key.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that you were supposed to be in that motel room when it blew up.
No way. You're crazy.
If your body would have been identified, there would have been no question about who the other corpse was. The police and the outfit would have thought that Frankie was dead.
You're sick, you know that? While you're talking, he could be getting killed. Now, does he have a deal?
Yeah, he's got a deal.
Thank you.
We're with the Department of Justice. We have a court order to take Frank Ferrantino into federal custody.
Get back! Go! Come on! Stop fighting now!
Frankie.
I told you to lay off, Vito. I said I would handle it.
Right, Ray, the move was already in motion. There was nothing I could do. Besides, my business is my business. I'll take care of it the way I see fit.
To come in, stay both shows just to see me. After the place closed, I used to go over there just to look at it, to remember the good times when Frankie wasn't like he is now.
People change, Teresa. You have to see Frankie for what he is now, not for what he was.
Maybe, but I love him.
You called. I'm out.
Three nines?
All right. King High straight.
How do you get that now?
Full boat, ladies over trays. If we was playing for money, boys, I think I'd have, what, about a year's salary by now?
If we were playing for money, you'd have about two broken hands by now.
What do you mean?
He cheats.
So sue me.
Whose deal?
Mine.
You stealing my wife or what?
Well, somebody ought to, Frankie. Somebody ought to take her right away from you.
Deal with the waiter.
I gave him the night off.
Let's do it.
All right, last hand. AC Deucey, One Eye Jacks Are Wild, Spit Black Mariah, Low Spade in the Hole, Splits the Pot.
What? Don't worry, Joe, you're not in.
All right.
I'm sorry, baby. I really am.
Yes, sure.
But I know I don't deserve you. I don't know why you stay with me. I mean, if you had any sense, you'd leave me. I mean, you might as well. I'm a dead man anyway.
The feds will keep you alive.
Yeah, sure they will.
Why do you hit me, Frankie?
Maybe because I'm jealous.
I wouldn't leave you. You know that. I couldn't.
Baby, I testify at this hearing. I'm a dead man.
That punk makes a deal with them. It could be very dangerous for me, for the entire Chicago outfit.
I understand that, Vito. But this is my town.
I know, and I'm sorry if my people stepped on your toes. They should have checked with me before they made their move, but they thought the girl could lead them to Farentino.
Manny has asked me to handle Frankie personally. You're welcome to stay in Vegas as long as you like. Go gambling, dance and see some shows. Better yet, go play some golf.
Thank you, Ray.
Manny's worried. Vito's unpredictable. If Frankie testifies and Vito gets indicted, Manny's afraid that Vito will roll over on the outfit rather than go to jail.
Vito's a stand-up guy, don't worry about it.
Maybe. Are we gonna be sure? Frankie's gotta be dealt with.
Hey, boss, let me handle it. I can handle it, ain't no problem.
A situation like this, you bring an out-of-town help. We don't need any extra heat. Go ahead, Max, make the call.
Operator, get me New York.
Smash it to you. Here you go.
How many cards?
Come on, sir.
Listen, baby, I gotta get out of here. Now. Just do it.
That offer that you made, immunity and a new identity in exchange for his testimony, is it still good?
I can call Washington.
Then do it, please, before something happens.
So. This girl, she plays the cello.
Mm-hmm.
She recites poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And she collects Japanese art.
Yeah, so?
I mean, what doesn't this girl do?
She doesn't bowl.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me. I beg your...
I should have been watching where I was going.
Oh, I... No, I should be watching where you're going.
Has anybody ever told you, Miss, that Miss...
Nah, I had it last night.
So what? Well, you know that worry out the waitress over lucky stuff?
Look at that.
Hey! Hey!
At least you could have done what said thanks.
You sure can't pick him.
Falling and I feel the pain, watching all the